We are going to continue with this strength series that I'm playing with the notion of having a foundation of ease. And what I want you to think about is, and this is not something I normally do, but I want you to think about watching birds fly. So whether it's bald eagles or whatever bird you love to watch fly, but it's got to be a big bird. And think about birds floating on thermals. And I want you to think about what that's like and how a bird catches a thermal and then just moves. So even though I'm going to be talking about some mechanics from a physical plane, I want to bring in this imagery of a bird on a thermal and finding that place of fluidity and ease and connection. That's where we build and be the strength that we want to be, right? We don't build the strength we want to be necessarily from our brain. We build it from this other level of connection. Now, before I get into the sequence, though, I've got one message that I need to bring forward, and that is, if you know anybody who is recovering from COVID, can you have them send me a direct message or an email through my site? We have found all sorts of stuff around ribcage, mobility and strength, shoulder girdle, overall core, pelvic stuff. And we're working with people who are recovering from COVID. So if you know someone who's struggling and who likes yoga and you think they would like me, then have them connect with me through DM on Instagram or on Facebook or through our website. I would love to support them. Okay, so please send them my way. All right, let's get into strength. So what we're going to begin with is we're going to begin on our I'm deciding which way to go. We're going to begin on our backs, okay? And we're here, and we're just going to let ourselves rest, feeling the feet on the floor and feeling our back on the mat. Easy, easy, easy breathing. And just feel yourself and feel your connection. And feel your feet. And then from here, rolling over and then come on up. And be here in tabletop now. And I just want you to feel your hands without pushing anything into the floor. Just feel. And then start to move through your pelvis, coming into a cow, and then moving into a cat, just moving sequentially through the spine, through the pelvis. So that as you go into your cow, you're in your inhale. And as you come into your cat, you're going through your exhale. Good. And then start to come up into standing. So now that you're in standing, sorry, that was a tree pin needle thing on my foot. All right, so here, when you take yourself into standing, bring your legs wide. All right, so you're feeling the three points on the bottom of your feet, the center of the heel, the ball of the foot, and the base of the pinky toe. I just want you to feel that, right? The legs have come wide through this hip area. And now I want you to rotate your leg bone, okay? And we're just going to connect nose and pubic bone, and we're just going to take a small movement into this position. I'm not calling it anything. I just want you to follow this movement. So you're moving through the hips. Okay, now I want you to use 5 to 10% less effort and do the same thing for wherever you're at. Five to 10% less effort, ribs to pelvis. Now, as I mentioned earlier, I want you now to imagine like one of those bald eagles a big bird catching a thermal and just following the thermal, and feel yourself moving as if you were a bald eagle, still within, obviously, your hips, connecting nose to pubic bone, but find a grace from the idea of the bird. Find the grace. And notice what happens when you find that grace, that connection to that rhythm of that eagle and the thermal, the eagle and the atmosphere. Find that within your movement here, yeah? Notice what happens with your legs and your feet. Maybe you're not trying as hard as you may have been, okay? Rotate. Good, and move. Find just a little bit more ease. Connect into that eagle. Feel the connection to the atmosphere, to nature's pull. Notice what happens with your tissue. As you blend in this physical plane of reality, being how our body moves, coming into Warrior Two now, to the greater natural laws of an eagle on the thermal. And we're just going to sink a little bit and then come back up. Think about the hips connecting to the feet. How much tension does an eagle use to ride a thermal? Arms out. How much tension are in the wings as an eagle rides a thermal? How much thinking is there as an eagle rides a thermal? Coming into side. Arm is up or arm is down. It's all about grace, fluidity. This elbow, we're not collapsing onto it. We're keeping an idea of lightness and then coming up. Good, and then up. Coming into Warrior Two, finding lightness. Lightness is not limpness. Lightness is not weakness. Beginning to move. But there's a connection between the palm and your belly and your feet that's just inherent in being able to ride a thermal. There's a whole book on creating a state of flow. Play around with where your arms are. Have it originate in between the connection of your torso through to your limbs. Moving obviously in the range that is available to you, but then also add in this other connecting part. Come back into standing. Now notice where you're at. Arms come up over your head, palms touch, hands come down. Arms come up over your head, palms touch, hands come down. Arms up over your head, palms touch, hands come down. One more. Take those three into a little sequence here. So we take the legs wide. Feel the eagle. feel the movement, 15% less effort, but still, it's not that you're taking away the result. Warrior two. It's that you actually are getting a better result. Back over to the other side, triangle. Extended side angle. And I kind of missed warrior two there, so we'll do warrior two here. All right, coming on up. Now notice. What's the level of ease? What's the level of strength? What's the inside and your outside, your top and your bottom? Moving forward into pyramid and hinging at the hips. So strength in many ways is a lot more ease. And if you lift weights or if you deadlift or you take things over your head or whatever it is that you do, play with that idea and see what happens. See what happens if you pick up your toddler kids into your arms or you're picking up a big bag of flour or rice and then come on up and come in here. Notice what happens when you consider ease as the foundation of strength. All right, let's come back down onto the floor. I'm just going to move my mat around a little. So coming back down onto the floor, one knee to your belly. Towards the sky. Feel where your pelvis is in place. And just play around with that knee. If you need to play around with the knee straightening, just what's going on through your pelvis. Good. And then bring that down. See, when you're building strength, you're coming from this place of awareness of where your parts already are in space. So you're not disregarding all the awareness work that you did earlier in order to get out of pain. You know and you can feel how your legs connect into your pelvis and your pelvis into your spine and how your pelvis relates to your ribcage. At this lower level, at this connection level. And then as you get that, you just take all of that awareness to your next level of strength. The next level of strength. You don't need to lose suppleness and flex. From this base of awareness, from this base and from this depth and from this container. Ease is what helps create. Easy breath here now. Let's move into butterfly. So from here, we're going to keep the feet where they are. We're not sliding into butterfly. We're going to rotate through the hip. Legs are going to come into rotation, and then they're going to come back. The foot edge. easy, easy breathing. All right, and then bring those legs back up. You can straighten them out or leave the feet flat on the floor with knees bent, totally up to you. So many people rush towards strength. So many people build strength on top of compensatory patterns that could be resolved. They build strength on a foundation of very, very weak awareness. And when you can take the gains of your awareness and build strength on top of that, that's when it becomes. Easy breathing. So as you move about today, as you move, if you're heading into bed tonight, if this is when you're following this, then take this as you move into your bedtime routine. Is just imagine how much more ease can you utilize to still have the same result. Less but better. That is what consistently bring more and more strength. So with that, have a really great rest of your day, and I will see you tomorrow morning with some more strength and balance and ease. Here we go.